I was in C.
You were in C. And the first one was in D. Boy, that's a pretty tune. I'm going to learn that in that.
Now, Jack does a nice job, and a lot of guys do. Now, it's on Sweet Bunch of Daisies, and they'll do
I had an 85-year-old lady sing that for me the other day, and she sang the verses.
Yeah.
And I've never heard the verses before, but it goes, a sweet bunch of daisies, da 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 da.
I'm from the Bay.
Yeah.
D.
G.
Daisies and Dale.
Yeah. I'll tell you who that was. That was Dr. Shelton's mother-in-law, Winnie's mother. She sang that. And the verses, and I've never heard the verses. I copied the words out of your book one time.
I'll sing you the music.
Okay.
If I haven't already.
Well, you played it before, and I recorded it.
I heard you talking about Pete last night, and did he have, now I knew he'd gotten sick again, but what's happened now? I mean, is this
he had a bypass,
again? When was this? When was it? 2 months ago, or?
2 weeks ago, Tuesday.
Well, I see, there. Said he had something, he'd been going down, hadn't he? Maybe that's what somebody told me.
Yeah, he kind of had inner ear problems.
Yeah, that was it. Somebody said his balance. He was having trouble with balance.
He was passing out.
Yeah.
It wasn't really bad.
Okay.
I think it was false.
Yeah.
They done tripped on him. He's
yeah. Well, he's come through
a
lot.
Let me tell you already, where they used to play that thing.
Told him he ought to have
that sweet bunch of daisies.
That's yeah. Why she sang that.
You know where Mac Mitchin and all those guys, that was their theme song. And even Red Heron still plays it in B flat.
Well, they reckon Pete plays in B flat.
Huh? Yeah, it's nice. I hear old Pete.
I've been playing G.
Thank you.
finish the verses, then you think you're just a repeat of the same melody.
Yeah, not many people play that part, last part. They don't even know it, don't they? Yeah.
Tell you, while I'm thinking about it, but I'll forget it. After Lonnie's son died, Jarrett Robertson, we were over there and we found a bunch of, he put out a bunch of 45s in the 60s. We found some of those. And she wants to get rid of them. I've got some in the car. She wants a buck a piece. There's 10 45s. And then she's got three LPs, $5 a piece.
Art Galbraith?
No, Lonnie Robertson. So if you're interested in any of them, let me know. There's some good stuff on those 45s. I've got a list of what's on those. I'll probably forget it now, so if you're interested, remind me.
Here's a song.
There's some good stuff on there.
This song's written in the key of G, C, and F. Has several names. The one I learned from the title was Down in the Old Cherry Orchard.
Down in the old what?
Cherry Orchard.
The Cherry Orchard.
Dodge and G.
Like that religious song, in the garden. Remind me of that in the garden, the very first part.
I picked this song up off of Canadians, but I found it on some old 78s with old labels, you know, the Challenger and that type of stuff. That Whitewater Jig, not Whitewater Jig, White River Stomp. That's been around a while. You ever hear that?
Yeah.
You know that, don't
you? And Whitewater Jig, too. We've heard them both.
Used to hear Tommy Jackson play that White Rock Jig.
That's where Art got a lot of that stuff, from Tommy Jackson.
I can't play White Rock Jig. One time, we entered a contest down on the Tennessee River, Chattanooga, and we had to play a jig, and then the South people, the same jigs, you know. If they play one, it's Sorry for the Woman, or Place of the Wedding, or something like that. So we decided, me and Wally Brown decided to play the Whitewater Jig. And you know what? We couldn't get that son of a buck started if we played another song. So we put it on tape. And the stage was a river broke barge. In the first place, money was $1,000. Well, we had our tunes all lined up, but we had anxieties about that one. So we had her on that tape. And back on the back side of that barge, with a stack of plywood about that high. And Walter Bryce was sitting back there with that tape recorder with that song on it. Well, Jack Weeks comes around and he says, let's all play the same jig. Walter says, I done got mine figured out. And I said, Walter, I'm going to talk to this MC. I went up and I said, say, does it matter which tune we play first? He said, no. I said, okay, thank you. I went back and said, Wally, we're going to play that jig first. And he left that tune in his mind as he walked away from that tape later on. We walked out there and be our luck, every song that we started, we hit that thing off just exactly right. And it teed off Jack and old Randy Howard bad. Wally walked away with that $1,000. But we was lucky, everything we did just fell in place. Now, oftentimes, if Wally got a bad start, it just progressively got worse.
What was the name of that one last night that's in F and A minor, D minor, I mean, that one? You showed me the chords on it. What was the name of that?
The Way That He Loves.
The Way That He Loves.
The Way That He Loves His Soul. Something
did you hear him play that? That's a pretty
Okay.
Now C 17. Do it again. It's before that.
Oh, I'm missing the beat.
Yeah. Stick it on in there.
Like, it's one note.
It's a passing chord, yeah. But it's there.
Oh, yeah, it goes there.
Play it, laughing boy, with me, Kenny. I'm still working on life. Every time somebody plays it for me, they can do that third part a little different. I'm going to try it. I saw a kid drop an ovation flat on his face on the concrete at the Gaslight Theater down in Nashville. He just walked over and the bleachers sat down and started crying.
Because I would.
Are ovations pretty valuable?
Not to me, they're not. can make a good large dipper or something like that.
Be a good oil free bowl.
When our son was 16 or 17, he bought an ovation and he doesn't play it much.
Acoustically, they ain't worth nothing.
Glenn Campbell was playing one at the time, you know, and he got that great thing.
But they got a good neck in them, and if they're record flat top, they're all right. As far as the custom, I can't handle them with a belly like I've got, and that bowl, they get my belly and that bowl on it. The guitar don't get along. A lot of people do.
The fellow with the plant.
That hurts you to see a good instrument
drop, though, doesn't it? But see, we know, you're nothing. It's your guitar we remember, see?
Yeah.
Got it here today? Later on, I'd like to. I was calling them LaPlante. It's LaPlante, isn't it? You say you knew Andreessen?
The over here is a little low. Clinton went somewhere down through there, Ruth. He went down to get them a ham and biscuit.
And I missed it somewhere on the way.
Here's a song I don't know the name of. So I picked it up in Germany. And I just called it a Hidelburg something.
Okay, let's hear it.
It's a simple thing. The bike didn't go on.
Oh, that's right. Okay. I started playing it about a year ago. I've had it at home. I had a Gibson.
You can play a German song. Hello there, Johnny.
The double on. I'm doing, see, and that's probably going to throw you off.
No.
Don't you make mistakes because I'm watching you.
Thank you.
mistakes I'm making. See, I don't plan on Kenny making mistakes, so I sit here and watch what he's doing, and he throws in some chords I don't recognize.
That's because I don't know where I'm at.
I've always got that song.
If you don't understand it, play Texas and you'll never miss it.
Yeah, that's right.
I called the Hidelburg Waltz.
Yeah. What was the key?
D. I picked that up. 45, I guess. In a railroad depot called the Bonhof something.
Well, now, did you have a fiddle with you?
No, I stole some over there. when the German houses were
gone. I mean, how'd you learn it? Did you just... your head or?
It was out of my head. I heard it while doing it. Why those Germans even during the war, somebody would have a little concertina. And they'd walk out in the street in one of those villages and start to play that oom-pa-pa stuff. And first thing you know, they'd be adding the numbers. They'd start following. Also, this gang of people following them down the street. One out front just to play in that squeeze box.
Say, I want to ask you something. My 89-year-old friend has an old violin that was made in Germany, and it just says copy of Nicholas Amati. But on the scroll up here, it's got Sarah Tate, S-A-R-A-T-A-T-E, and then a big star. Now, what does Sarah Tate, have you ever heard it? Have you ever seen a violin with that? It must be an old one.
I don't really know.
And it does sound very fine. But I thought maybe you might have
seen it. I got a German. It's got a German. It's made in Germany. But everything about it, wherever I put it, everything about thing looks French to me. Whereas this don't come down, it's like there's no label there. I think it's a Schweitzer. The copy of that. Of course, Schweitzer was a copy himself. He copied Amati and Strad. This is Amati.
You would have to
play
Georgiana Moon and D flat. Would you like Kenny Baker?
Play what?
Georgiana Moon and D flat.
I can try. I don't know whether I'd do it like Baker or not.
Well, I don't know. I learned some chords to it that way. I just nobody ever plays it.
Oh, I don't know how he does. I never heard him play.
Well, that's the chords fitted what you were doing. That's
we played the B flat.
That's what he wanted.
Yeah.
B flat chords.
Yeah, but B flat's where I learned these chords. Then nobody ever plays it in B flat, so I didn't get a chance to practice it.
Let's play Ashokin. Farewell again.